What is the next number in the series 1, 4, 13 and 40? We are asked the next number in the series. Remember, series, we may also refer to it as number sequence. We can proceed to solution. We have said that series, we may also refer to it as number sequence. And number sequence refers to a group of numbers which are arranged or written in a certain order. We have said that series are groups of numbers which are written in a certain order. For us to get the missing number in a series, we first establish an appropriate rule. And remember, the rule may be either based on addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, squares, square roots, prime numbers, odd numbers, and even numbers. From there, we can proceed to search for our next number in our series. And in our series, we have 1, 4, 13, and 40. We want to search for this next number. For us to get this, our next number, we are first going to search for the difference. From 1 to 4, we have a difference of 3. Again, from 4 to 13, we have a difference of 9. From 13 to 40, we have a difference of 27. These 3, 9, and 27 will help us to search for our next number in the series. Remember our rule here, we have the powers of 3. In our case, we have 3 power 1 to give us 3. We have 3 power 2 to give us 9. We have 3 power 3 to give us 27. Therefore, our next rule will be 3 power 4 to give us 81. Remember, when we say power, we are meaning that we take the number which is 3, we multiply with itself in the number of times. In our case here, we have 3 power 4. 3 power 4 is written as 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. This will give us 81. Therefore, in our next rule, we have said that it will be 3 power 4 to give us 81. For us to get this next number here, we are going to take our 81, we had 40. 81, when we had 40, we are going to get 121. Therefore, our next number here will be 121. Our correct answer is B. What is the next number in the following pattern, which is 4, 7, 16, and 31? We can proceed to solution. Remember, in our case, we are asked the next number in the pattern. And for us to get the next number in our pattern, we are first going to establish our rule. Our rule in our case will be based on odd numbers. Remember, odd numbers are numbers which cannot be divisible by 2. we can now proceed to search for our next number in our pattern. We have 4, 7, 16, and 31. We want to search for this next number. We are first going to search for the difference. From 4 half to 7, we have a difference of 3. From 7 half to 16, we have a difference of 9. From 16 half to 31, we have a difference of 15. For us to get this next number in our pattern, we are first going to list odd numbers. We are going to list these odd numbers starting from 3 up to 25. And our odd numbers will be as follows. We have 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19, 21, 23, and 25. Remember, 3, 9, and 15 are odd numbers. And in our case, from 3 up to 9, we have jumped 5 and 7. From 9 up to 15, we have jumped 11 and 13. Therefore, for us to get our next number, we are going to jump our 17 and 19. Therefore, it will be from 15 up to 21. We can proceed as follows. We are going to come from 3 up to 9. Then we proceed from 9 up to 15. We proceed from 15 up to 21. For us to get this next number in our pattern, we are going to take 21, we add 31. And when we add 31 with 21, we are going to get 52. Therefore, our next number in our pattern will be 52. Our correct answer is A. What is the next number in the pattern below? We have our pattern, which is 1, 2, 5, 10 and 17. We are asked the next number in our pattern. We can proceed to solution. For us to get the next number in our pattern, we are first going to establish the rule. And in our case here, the rule will be based on odd numbers. Remember, odd numbers are numbers which cannot be divisible by 2. We can now proceed to search for our next number in our pattern. We have 1, 2, 5, 10, and 17. We want to search for this next number in our pattern. And for us to get the next number in the pattern, we are first going to search for the difference. From 1 up to 2, we have a difference of 1. From 2 up to 5, we have a difference of 3. From 5 up to 10, we have a difference of 5. Again, from 10 up to 17, we have a difference of 7. We have 1, 3, 5, and 7. Remember, this 1, 3, 5, and 7 are odd numbers. For us to get our next number in our pattern, we are therefore going to search for the next odd number. From 7, our next odd number will be 9. Therefore, the next number in our pattern here will be 9. We had 17. We can now proceed to addition. We have 9, we had 17. 9, when we had 17, we are going to get 26. Therefore, the next number in our pattern will be 26. Our correct answer is D. What is the next number in the sequence below? We are asked the next number in our sequence, which is 0, 3, 9, 18, and 30. We can proceed to solution. And for us to get the next number in our sequence, we are first going to establish the rule. And our rule here is based on multiples of 3. We can now proceed to search for the next number in the sequence. And our sequence is as follows. We have 0, 3, 9, 18, and 30. We can first proceed to search for the difference. From 0 up to 3, we have a difference of 3. From 3 up to 9, we have a difference of 6. From 9 up to 18, we have a difference of 9. From 18 up to 30, we have a difference of 12. Therefore, we have 3, 6, 9, and 12. And we have said that these are multiples of 3. For us to get the next number in our sequence, we are therefore going to search for the next multiple of 3 after 12. The next multiple of 3 after 12 will be 15. Therefore, our number which is missing in our sequence here will be 30. We had 15. 30, when we had 15, we are going to get 45. Therefore, our next number in our sequence here will be 45. Our correct answer is B. What is the next number in the sequence below? We have our sequence, which is 2, 6, 12, 20, and 30. We are asked the next number in the sequence. We can therefore proceed to solution. For us to get the next number in our sequence, we are therefore first going to establish the rule. And the rule in our sequence will be even numbers. Remember, even numbers here are the numbers which are divisible by 2. They are also the multiples of 2. From there, we can proceed to search for our next number in the sequence. And our sequence is as follows. We have 2, 6, 12, 20, and 30. We want to search for this next number in the sequence. From there, we are therefore going to search for the difference. From 2 up to 6, we have a difference of 4. From 6 up to 12, we have a difference of 6. From 12 up to 20, we have a difference of 8. From 20 up to 30, we have a difference of 10. And we have said 4, 6, 8 and 10 are even numbers. Therefore, for us to get the next number in our sequence here, we are therefore going to search for the next even number after 10. After 10 here, our next even number will be 12. Therefore, our next number in our sequence here will be 30. We had 12. 30, when we had 12, we are going to get 42. Therefore, our next number in the sequence will be 42. Our correct answer is D. Which one of the following groups of numbers is arranged in an ascending order? We are asked which of the following groups of numbers is arranged in ascending order. Remember, ascending order is starting from the smallest up to the largest. For us to know which groups of numbers is arranged in ascending order, we are therefore going to compare the last three digits formed by our groups of numbers. We can now proceed to solution. In our question, we are asked which of the following groups of numbers is arranged in ascending order. And we have said that ascending order is starting from the smallest up to the largest. And for us to know which group of numbers is arranged in ascending order, we have said that we are going to compare the last three digits formed by our groups of numbers. We are going to work with our answers. We can now proceed to our first choice, which is choice A. In this choice A, we have the last three digits formed by our groups of numbers as follows. We have 320 followed by 302 followed by 203 and finally we have 23. Therefore, the last three digits formed in our groups of numbers in our choice A, we have found that we have 320 followed by 302 followed by 203 and finally we have 23. These numbers have been arranged in descending order. Remember, descending order is starting from the largest up to the smallest. We can now proceed to prove for our choices, which are in choice B. Our last three digits in our groups of numbers in choice B are as follows. We have 320 followed by 302 followed by 23 and 302. In this case, we have this 23 and 302. These numbers, if arranged in ascending order, we are going to find that 22,023 should come the last number. We can now proceed to prove our choice C. And the groups of numbers are as follows. The last three digits formed in these groups of numbers in choice C, we have 23, 203, 302, and 320. We have said that the last three digits in our choice C formed by our numbers, we have 23 followed by 203 followed by 302, and finally we have 320. When we look at 23, 203, 302, and finally 320, we find that they have been arranged in ascending order. Remember, ascending order is starting from the smallest, proceeding onwards to the largest. Therefore, our groups of numbers which are arranged in ascending order will be 22,023, followed by 22,203, followed by 22,302, and finally 22,320. Our correct answer is C. What is the next number in the sequence below? We are asked the next number in the sequence, which is 57, 43, 31, and 21. We are asked this next number. We can therefore proceed to solution. And for us to get the next number in our sequence, we are first going to establish the rule. And in our case here, the rule is based on even numbers. These even numbers are arranged in descending order. We can now proceed to search for the next number in our sequence. And our sequence is as follows. We have 57 followed by 43 followed by 31 followed by 21. We want to search for this next number in our sequence. We are therefore going to search for the difference. From 57 up to 43, we have a difference of 14. From 43 up to 31, we have a difference of 12. From 31 up to 21, we have a difference of 10. We have 14, 12, and 10. Remember, these are even numbers. And these even numbers are arranged in descending order, starting from the largest, proceeding onwards to the smallest. Therefore, our next even number after 10 here, proceeding downwards, will be 8. From 21 here, we are going to subtract 8. Therefore, we are going to take our 21, we subtract 8. 21, when we subtract 8, we are going to get 13. Therefore, our next number in our sequence here will be 13. Our correct answer is B. What is the next number in the sequence below? We are asked the next number in the sequence below, which is 4, 11, 22, and 37. We want to search for this next number in our sequence. We can proceed to solution. For us to get the next number in our sequence, we are first going to establish the rule. And our rule here will be based on odd numbers. Remember, odd numbers are numbers which cannot be divisible by 2. We can now proceed to first search for the difference. Remember, our sequence is as follows. We have 4, 11, 22 and 37. We want to search for this next number in our sequence. And we have said we are first going to search for the difference between the numbers in our sequence. From 4 up to 11, we have a difference of 7. From 11 up to 22, we have a difference of 11. From 22 up to 37, we have a difference of 15. 7, 11, and 15 are odd numbers. For us to get this next number in our sequence, we are therefore going first to list our odd numbers starting from 7, proceeding onwards up to 23. We can now proceed to list the odd numbers. We are going to start with 7. 7 will be followed by 9. We have 11, we have 13, we have 15, we have 17, we have 19, we have 21, and finally we have 23. Again, from 7 up to 11, we have jumped 9. Therefore, from 11 up to 15, we have jumped 13. We are going to jump 17. We proceed onwards to 19. It will be as follows. From 7 up to 11, we have jumped 9. From 11, we are going to jump 13. We proceed to 15. From 15, we are going to jump 17. We proceed to 19. For us to get this next number in our sequence here, we are going to take our 37, we add 19. We can proceed to addition. It will be 37, we add 19. 37, when we add 19, we are going to get 56. Therefore, our next number in our sequence will be 56. Our correct answer is C. Which one of the following number patterns increases by 100 only? We are asked which of the following number patterns increases by 100 only. We can proceed to solution. For us to search for the number patterns which increases by 100 only, we are going to work with answers. We can now proceed to search for the choices which are given in A. They increase by how much? Remember, in our choice A, we have 6,200, 7,200, 8,200, 9,200. We want to search for the number patterns in choice A increase by how much. We are going to take 7,200, we subtract 6,200. 7,200, when we subtract 6,200, we are going to get 1,000. Therefore, the number patterns formed by choice A increase by 1,000. We can now proceed to search for the number patterns formed by choice B increase by how much. And in our B, we have 5,100 followed by 5,110 followed by 5,120 and finally 5,130. We want to search for the number patterns formed by our choice B increase by how much. Therefore, we are going to take 5,110. We subtract 5,100. 5,110. When we subtract 5,100, we are going to get 10. Therefore, the number patterns formed by our choice B increase by 10. Remember, we are asked which of the following number patterns increases by 100 only. We can now proceed to search for the number patterns formed by our choice C increase by how much. Remember, our choice C is formed by 4040 followed by 4140 followed by 4240 and finally 4340. We want to search for the number patterns formed in our choice C increases by how much. We are going to take the difference between 4140 and 4040. 4140, when we subtract 4040, we are going to get 100. Therefore, the number patterns which increases by 100 only will be our choice C. We have 4040 followed by 4140, 4240 and finally 4340. Our correct answer is C. What is the next number in the sequence below? We have our sequence which is 2, 5, 14 and 41. We are asked the next number in our sequence. We can proceed to solution. For us to get the next number in our sequence, we are first going to establish the rule. And when we establish our rule in our sequence, we are going to find that we have the powers of 3. We have said that our rule will be based on powers of 3. Remember, we have 3 raised to 1, which is the same as 3 power 1 to give us 3. We also have 3 power 2 to give us 9. We have 3 power 3 to give us 27. And again, we have 3 power 4 to give us 81. From there, we can proceed first to search for the difference. Remember, we are searching for the difference between our numbers which form our sequence. And our sequence is as follows. We have 2 followed by 5. We have 14 and we have 41. We want to search for this next number in our sequence. We are first going to search for the difference. From 2 up to 5, we have a difference of 3. From 5 up to 14, we have a difference of 9. From 14 up to 41, we have a difference of 27. Remember, this 3 is the same as 3 power 1 to give us 3. This 9 here is the same as 3 power 2 to give us 9. It can be written as 3 times 3, which gives us 9. We have our 27 here, and our 27 is the same as 3 power 3 to give us 27. It can be written as 3 times 3 times 3. Therefore, for us to get our next number in our sequence, we are first going to search for the result of 3 power 4. And 3 power 4 will be written as 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. This will give us 81. Therefore, from 41, we are going to add 81. For us to get this next number in our sequence here, we are going to take 41, we add 81. We can therefore proceed to addition. We have our 41, we had 81. 41, when we had 81, we are going to get 122. Therefore, our next number in our sequence will be 122. Our correct answer is D. 4 numbers are given as follows. We have 557,231. We have 535,721. 571,351. And finally, we have 523,571. By how much is the largest number more than the smallest number? We are asked by how much is the largest number more than the smallest number. We can proceed to solution. For us to know by how much is the largest number more than the smallest number, we are first going to search for the largest number. And in our case here, our largest number is 571,351. We have said that our largest number is 571,351. We can proceed to search for our smallest number. And our smallest number in our case will be 523,571. We have said that our smallest number will be 523,571. We can now proceed to take the difference. We are going to take the largest number, we subtract the smallest number. And this is our largest number, and this is our smallest number. We can proceed to take the difference. It will be 571,351. We subtract 523,571. 571,351. When we subtract 523,571, we are going to get 47,780. In our case here, our largest number is more than the smallest number by 47,780. Our correct answer is D. What is the next number in the sequence? We are asked the next number in our sequence, which is 1, 5, 13, 25, and 41. We can proceed to solution. For us to get the next number in our sequence, we are first going to establish the rule. When we establish our rule, we are going to find that the rule will be based on multiples of 4. From there, we can proceed to search for our next number in our sequence. Our sequence is as follows. We have 1 followed by 5. We have 13 followed by 25. And finally, we have 41. We want to search for this next number in our sequence. And for us to get this next number in our sequence, we are first going to search for the difference. From 1 up to 5, we have a difference of 4. From 5 up to 13, we have a difference of 8. From 13 up to 25, we have a difference of 12. From 25 up to 41, we have a difference of 16. We have 4, 8, 12, and 16. Remember this, we have said that they are multiples of 4. For us to get our next number in our sequence, we are therefore going to search for the next multiple of 4 after 16. And the next multiple of 4 after 16, we are going to find that it will be 20. Therefore, for us to get this next number in our sequence, we are going to take 41, we had 20. We can now proceed to addition. We have our 41, we had 20. 41, when we had 20, we are going to get 61. Therefore, the next number in our sequence will be 61. Our correct answer is B. What is the next number in the sequence? We are asked the next number in the sequence, which is 7, 16, 32, and 57. We can proceed to solution. For us to get the next number in our sequence, we are first going to establish the rule. Remember here, the rule will be based on squares of whole numbers. We can now proceed to search for our next number in our sequence. And our sequence is as follows. We have 7, 16, 32, and 57. We want to search for this next number in our sequence. We are therefore first going to search for the difference between the numbers which form our sequence. From 7 up to 16, we have a difference of 9. From 16 up to 32, we have a difference of 16. From 32 up to 57, we have a difference of 25. In our case, we have 9, 16, and 25. Remember, 9 is the square of 3. 16 is the square of 4. Again, our 25 here is the square of 5. For us to get our next number in our sequence here, we are therefore going to search for the square of 6. And the square of 6 will be 6. We multiply with 6 to give us 36. Therefore, we are going to take our 57 here. We had 36. 57, when we had 36, we are going to get 93. Therefore, our next number in our sequence will be 93. Our correct answer is A. What is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in our pattern, which is 2, 6, 11, and 17. We want to search for this next number in our pattern. We can now proceed to solution. And in our case, our pattern is as follows. We have 2, 6, 11, and 17. We want to search for this next number in our pattern. We can now proceed to search for the difference between the numbers which make up our pattern. From 2 up to 6, we have a difference of 4. From 6 up to 11, we have a difference of 5. From 11 up to 17, we have a difference of 6. We have 4, 5, and 6. Therefore, our next number here will be 7. For us to get our next number in our pattern here, we are going to take 17. We had 7. We can now proceed to addition. We have 17. We had 7. 17, when we had 7, we are going to get 24. Therefore, our next number in our pattern will be 24. Our correct answer is B. What is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in the pattern, which is 84, 62, 43, and 27. We are asked this next number in the pattern. And remember, our pattern here is decreasing. We can now proceed to solution. We are first going to search for the difference between the numbers which form our pattern. And remember, our pattern is as follows. We have 84, 62, 43, and 27. We want to search for this next number in our pattern. We can first search for the difference between the numbers which make up our pattern. From 84 up to 62, we have a difference of 22. From 62 up to 43, we have a difference of 19. Again, from 43 up to 27, we have a difference of 16. We have 22, 19, and 16. We can now also proceed to search for the difference of the numbers which are 22, 19, and 16. From 22 up to 19, we have subtracted 3. From 19 up to 16, we have also subtracted 3. Therefore, for us to get our next number here, we are going to take 16, we subtract 3. And in our case here, 16, when we subtract 3, we are going to get 13. Therefore, our number here will be 13. And remember, we want to search for the next number in our pattern. For us to get the next number in our pattern here, we are going to take 27, we subtract 13. Therefore, our next number here in our pattern, we have said that it will be 27. We subtract 13 to give us 14. Therefore, our next number here in our pattern will be 14. Our correct answer is B. What is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in our pattern, which is formed by the numbers which are 3, 4, 7, 11, and 18. We can proceed to solution. Remember, we are asked the next number in our pattern. Our pattern is formed by the numbers which are as follows. We have 3, 4, 7, 11, and 18. We want to search for next number in our pattern. In our case here, 3, we have added 4 to give us 7. This 7, we have added 11 to give us 18. Our next number here, we are going to take 18. We had the previous number, which is 11. Therefore, it will be 18. We had 11 to give us 29. 29 will be our next number in our pattern. Remember, we have said that 4, when we had 3, will give us 7. 11, when we had 7, will give us 18. For us to get this next number here, we are going to take 18. We had 11 to give us 29. The next number in our pattern will be 29. Our correct answer is D. What is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in our pattern, which is 1, 3, 7, and 15. We can proceed to solution. We are asked the next number in our pattern. And for us to get the next number in our pattern, we are first going to establish the rule which is formed by the pattern. And when we establish our rule here, we are going to find that our rule will be based on powers of 2. Remember, we have 2 power 1 to give us 2. We also have 2 power 2 to give us 4. We have 2 power 3 to give us 8. We also have 2 power 4 to give us 16. From there, we can proceed first to search for our next number in our pattern. And our pattern is as follows. We have 1, 3, 7, and 15. We want to search for our next number in our pattern. And for us to search for our next number in our pattern, we are first going to search for the difference between the numbers which form our pattern. From 1 up to 3, we have a difference of 2. From 3 up to 7, we have a difference of 4. From 7 up to 15, we have a difference of 8. Remember, 2, we have said that is the same as 2 power 1 to give us 2. We also have our 4 here. Our 4 here is the same as 2 power 2, which is also written as 2 times 2 to give us 4. We have our 8 here. Our 8 will be written as 2 power 3, which is the same as 2 times 2 times 2 to give us 8. Therefore, for us to get our next number in our pattern, we are going to search for the result of 2 power 4, and finally we had 15. We have our 2 power 4, which is written as 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 to give us 16. Remember, we want to search for our next number in our pattern. And for us to get our next number in our pattern, we are going to take our 15, we had 16. Therefore, we are now going to add 15 with 16. 15, when we add 16, we are going to get 31. Therefore, our next number in our pattern will be 31. Our correct answer is D. What is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in our pattern, which is 16, 44, 82, and 130. We can proceed to solution. For us to get our next number in our pattern, we are first going to establish the rule formed by the pattern. We can now proceed to search for our next number in our pattern. Remember, our pattern is as follows. We have 16, 44, 82, and 130. We want to search for this next number in our pattern. For us to get our next number in our pattern, we are also going to search for the difference between the numbers which form our pattern. From 16 up to 44, we have a difference of 28. From 44 up to 82, we also have a difference of 38. From 82 up to 130, we have a difference of 48. We have 28, 38, and 48. For us to get our next number here in our pattern, we are going to take our 48, we had 10. Therefore, our next number here in our pattern, we are going to take 48, we had 10, and we had the result to 130. 48, when we had 10, we are going to get 58. Remember, for us to get this next number in our pattern, we are going to take 130, we had 58. We can proceed to addition. We have 130, we had 58. 130, when we had 58, we are going to get 188. We have said that 130, when we had 58, we are going to get 188. Therefore, our next number in our pattern will be 188. Our correct answer is A. What is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in our pattern, which is 1, 4, 10, and 19. We can proceed to solution. For us to get the next number in our pattern, we are first going to establish the rule which is formed by the pattern. And when we establish the rule which is formed by the pattern, we are going to find that the rule will be based on multiples of 3. From there, we can now proceed to search for our next number in our pattern. And our pattern is as follows. We have 1, 4, 10, and 19. We want to search for this next number in our pattern. We are first going to search for the difference between the numbers which form our pattern. From 1 up to 4, we have a difference of 3. From 4 up to 10, we have a difference of 6. From 10 up to 19, we have a difference of 9. Therefore, we have said that our rule here is based on multiples of 3. 3, 6, and 9 are both multiples of 3. Therefore, we are going to search for the next multiple of 3 after 9. And the next multiple of 3 after 9 will be 12. For us to get our next number in our pattern, we are going to take 19, we had 12. We can now proceed to addition. We have 19, we had 12. 19, when we had 12, we are going to get 31. Therefore, the next number in our pattern will be 31. Our correct answer is C. What is the next number in the sequence? We are asked the next number in the sequence, which is formed by 6, 13, 24, and 37. We can now proceed to solution. For us to get the next number in our sequence, we are first going to establish for the rule formed by our sequence. Our rule here, we are going to find that it is based on prime numbers. Remember, prime numbers are numbers which only have 2 divisors. We can now proceed to search for our next number in the sequence. Therefore, our sequence, we have said that it is formed by 6, 13, 24, and 37. We can first search for the difference between the numbers which form our sequence. From 6 half to 13, we have 7. From 13 up to 24, we have 11. From 24 up to 37, we have 13. We want to search for our next number in our pattern. Remember, 7, 11, and 13 are prime numbers. Therefore, for us to get our next number in our sequence, we are first going to search for the next prime number which comes after 13. And our next prime number which comes after 13 will be 17. For us to get this next number in our sequence, we are going to take 37, we had 17. We can now proceed to addition. We have 37, we had 17. 37, when we had 17, we are going to get 54. Therefore, our next number in our sequence will be 54. Our correct answer is C. What is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in our pattern, which is formed by 10, 11, 15, 24, 40, and 65. 5. We want to search for the next number in our pattern. We can now proceed to solution. And for us to get the next number in our pattern, we are first going to establish the rule formed by our pattern. When we establish the rule, we are going to find that the rule is based on squares of whole numbers. We can now proceed to search for our next number in our pattern, and our pattern is as follows. We have 10, 11, 15, 24, 40, and 65. We want to search for our next number in our pattern, and for us to get our next number in our pattern, we are first going to search for the difference between the numbers which form our pattern. From 10 up to 11, we have added 1. From 11 up to 15, we have added 4. From 15 up to 24, we have added 9. From 24 up to 40, we have added 16. Again, from 40 up to 65, we have added 25. When we look at our numbers here, we are going to find that they are squares of whole numbers. 1 is the square of 1. 4 will be the square of 2. Our 9 here is the square of 3. 16 is the square of 4. 25 is the square of 5. Therefore, our next whole number will be 6. And we are now going to search for the square of 6. Remember, for us to get the square of 6, we are going to take 6. We multiply with 6 to give us 36. We want to search for this next number in our pattern. And for us to get our next number in our pattern, we are going to take 65. We had 36. We can now proceed to addition. We have our 65. We had 36. 65, when we had 36, we are going to get 101. Therefore, our next number in our pattern will be 101. Our correct answer is B. What is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in the pattern, which is formed by 4, 9, 25, 49, 121, and finally 169. We can proceed to solution. For us to get the next number in our pattern, we are first going to establish the rule formed by our pattern. We are going to find that the rule is based on squares of prime numbers. Remember, prime numbers here are numbers which only have two divisors. We can now proceed to search for the next number in our pattern. And our pattern is formed by the numbers which are as follows. We have 4, 9, 25, 49, 121, and finally 169. We want to search for the next number in our pattern. We have said that our rule in our pattern is based on squares of prime numbers. Therefore, for us to get Our next number in our pattern, we are first going to list the prime numbers which are between 1 up to 17. We have the prime numbers as follows. We have 2 followed by 3. We have 5, 7, 11, 13, and 17. In our case here, 4 is the square of 2. 9 is the square of 3. 25 is the square of 5. 49 is the square of 7. 121 is the square of 11. 169 is the square of 13. For us to get our next number in our pattern, we are therefore going to search for the square of the next prime number after 13. And our next prime number will be 17. Therefore, we are going to search for the square of 17. It will be 17. We multiply with 17 to give us 289. Therefore, the next number in our pattern will be 289. Our correct answer is A. What is the next number in the pattern below? We are asked the next number in the pattern, which is formed by the numbers, which is 2, 6, 12, 20, and 30. We want to search for this next number in our pattern. We can now proceed to solution. And for us to get the next number in our pattern, we are first going to establish the rule formed by our pattern. And our rule here is based on even numbers. Remember, these even numbers are also multiples of 2. We can now proceed to search for our next number in our pattern. And our pattern is formed by the numbers which are 2, 6, 12, 20, and 30. We want to search for the next number in our pattern. We are first going to search for the difference between the numbers which form our pattern. From 2 up to 6, we have added 4. From 6 up to 12, we have added 6. From 12 up to 20, we have added 8. From 20 up to 30, we have added 10. We want to search for our next number in our pattern. Remember, these are even numbers which are also multiples of 2. For us to get our next number in our pattern, we are therefore going to search for the next multiple of 2 after 10. And the next multiple of 2 after 10, we are going to find that it will be 12. Therefore, our next number in our pattern, we are going to take 30. We had 12. We can now proceed to addition. 30, when we had 12, we are going to get 42. Therefore, our next number in our pattern will be 42. Our correct answer is C. What is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in the pattern, which is formed by the numbers 7, 12, 19, 30, and 43. We can now proceed to solution. Remember, we are asked the next number in our pattern. And for us to get the next number in our pattern, we are first going to establish the rule formed by our pattern. We can now proceed to establish the rule formed by our pattern. Our rule here, we are going to find that it is based on prime numbers. Remember, prime numbers here are numbers which have only two divisors. We can now proceed to search for our next number in our pattern. And remember, our pattern is formed by numbers which are as follows. We have 7, 12, 19, 30, and 43. We want to search for the next number in our pattern. And for us to get the next number in our pattern, we are first going to search for the difference between the numbers which form our pattern. Therefore, from 7 up to 12, we have 5. From 12 up to 19, we have added 7. From 19 up to 30, we have added 11. From 30 up to 43, we have added 13. Remember, 5, 7, 11, and 13 are prime numbers. Therefore, we are now going to search for our next prime number after 13. Our next prime number after 13, we are going to find that it will be 17. For us to get this next number in our pattern, we are going to take 43, we had 17. We can now proceed to addition. 43, when we had 17, in our case, we are going to get 60. Therefore, the next number in our pattern here will be 60. Our correct answer is B. What is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in the pattern, which is formed by 5, 13, 25, 41, and 61. We can now proceed to solution. And for us to get the next number in our pattern, we are first going to establish the rule formed in our pattern. Our rule here, we are going to find that it is based on even numbers. Remember, even numbers are numbers which can be divisible by 2. We can now proceed to search for our next number in our pattern. Remember, our pattern is formed by the numbers which are as follows. We have 5, 13, 25, 41, and 61. We want to search for the next number in our pattern. Therefore, we are first going to search for the difference between the numbers which form our pattern. From 5 up to 13, we have added 8. From 13 up to 25, we have added 12. From 25 up to 41, we have added 16. Again, from 41 up to 61, we have added 20. Remember, these are even numbers and are also multiples of 4. For us to get our next number in our pattern, we are first going to search for the next multiple of 4 after 20. And the next multiple of 4 after 20 will be 24. Therefore, for us to get this number here, we are going to take 61, we had 24. Therefore, our next number in our pattern here, we have said that it will be 61. We had 24. 61, when we had 24, we are going to get 85. Therefore, the next number in our pattern will be 85. Our correct answer is B. What is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in our pattern, which is formed by 3, 10, 5, 12, 7, 14, 9, and 16. We can now proceed to solution. For us to get our next number in our pattern, we are first going to establish the rule formed by our pattern. Our rule, we are going to find that it is based on even numbers and odd numbers. From there now, we can proceed to search for our next number in our pattern. And our pattern is formed by 3, 10, 5, 12, 7, 14, 9, and 16. We want to search for this next number in our pattern. Remember, we have said that the rule of our pattern is based on even numbers and odd numbers. We have 3, 5, 7, and 9. These are odd numbers. We also have 10, 12, 14, and 16, which are our even numbers. We can now proceed to search for our next number in our pattern. From 3, we have proceeded to the next odd number, which is 5. From 5, our next odd number will be 7. From 7, our next odd number will be 9. Therefore, for us to get our next number in our pattern here, we are going to search for the next odd number, which comes after 9. And the next odd number which comes after 9 will be 11. Therefore, our next number in our pattern here, we have found that it will be 11. Our correct answer is A. What is the difference between the next two numbers in the pattern? We are asked the difference between the next two numbers in the pattern, which is formed by 4, 9, 25, 49, and 121. We can proceed to solution. And in our question, remember, we are asked the difference between the next two numbers in our pattern. For us to get the difference, we are first going to search for these two numbers in our pattern. And for us to get these two numbers in our pattern, we are first going to establish the rule formed by our pattern. We are going to find that the rule is based on squares of prime numbers. Remember, prime numbers are numbers which only have two divisors. We can now proceed to search for our next two numbers in our pattern. And our pattern is formed by 4, 9, 25, 49, and 121. We want to search for the next two numbers in our pattern. We have said that the rule of our pattern is based on squares of prime numbers. We can first list prime numbers from 2 up to 15. And our prime numbers will be as follows. We have 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, and 17. Therefore, 4 here is the square of 2. 9 is the square of 3. 25 is the square of 5. 49 is the square of 7. 121 is the square of 11. For us to get this next number here, we are going to search for the square of 13. Remember, our 13 squared here will be the same as 13 multiplied with 13 to give us 169. In our case here, this next number here will be 169. We can now proceed to search for the next number here. And for us to get this next number, we are going to search for the square of the next prime number which comes after 13. And our next prime number which comes after 13 will be 17. We can now proceed to search for the square of 17. It will be 17. We multiply with 17 to give us 289. Our next number here will be 289. Remember, we are asked the difference between the next two numbers in our pattern. And we have found that the next two numbers in our pattern, we have 169 and 289. We can now proceed to take the difference. It will be 289. We subtract 169. 289, when we subtract 169, we are going to get 120. Therefore, the difference between the next two numbers in our pattern will be 120. Our correct answer is A. Which is the next number in the pattern? We are asked the next number in the pattern. We can now proceed to solution. For us to get the next number in the pattern, we are first going to establish the rule formed by our pattern. Then our rule here, we are going to find that it is based on powers of 3. We can now proceed to search for our next number in our pattern. And our pattern is as follows. We have 1, 3, 9, 27, and 81. We want to search for this next number in our pattern. In our case here, 3 is the same as 3 power 1 to give us 3. We have 9. 9 in our case is the same as 3 power 2, which is written as 3 times 3 to give us 9. Again, we have our 27 here. Our 27 here is the same as 3 power 3, which is written as 3 times 3 times 3, which gives us 27. We have our 81 here. Then again, our 81 is the same as 3 power 4, which is also written as 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. This 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 gives us 81. Therefore, our next number in our pattern will be 3 power 5. This is the same as 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 times 3. 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 times 3 is written as 3 power 5, which gives us 243. Therefore, our next number in our pattern will be 243. Our correct answer is D.